Konnichiwa, Satoe from Hong Kong chapter of Japan Reiki Association. I'm teaching Reiki here in Hong Kong. Today, I'd like to talk about the topic. It's about highly sensitive person. So I found this the word in YouTube. So some people talking about highly sensitive person. Actually, what's highly sensitive person? I believe that this is highly sensitive to energy person. Yeah, since I'm teaching Reiki and I understand about what's energy, so how energy really influence us is very important. So if you can treat our energy well, so I think you can spend a very different day from today on. Yeah, but what is the highly sensitive person? For example, have you ever experienced following things? For example, if you go down the street and then you suddenly tired, you feel easily tired but don't know what's the reason. You have some emotion created, but that emotion not from your own emotion, as if suddenly created one emotion without any reason. So that's also sensitive person. Yeah. Do you have any symptoms that you have to sleep enough, sleep really long enough so that you feel really energetic next day? That's also, I think that some research telling about that highly sensitive person usually need to have enough energy. That's also, I guess, is a very, I think they are also possibly like a very sensitive person. Actually, what happened to those sensitive person? You can imagine energy, because energy is invisible. Yeah, talk about energy. For example, we have energy in the body. Yeah, like Oriental medicine or Chinese medicine, we talk about blood, we talk about lymph node, and we talk about energy. That energy is flowing through your body. But where does this energy come from? Actually, we are absorbing energy all the time. And then sometimes we also, for example, we do communication with others, and we can nicely sense the people's emotion. For example, yeah, I don't think this is a special talent, but everybody can do. For example, when you look at a person and then you still didn't start a conversation, but you can sense the person, maybe they are not happy, or they look really sick, or you know, look at the face color, all those things, actually they are all telling about their emotion today or physical condition today. So sometimes you carefully look, you understand. So that's also our sense to feel energy. Yeah, I guess so. But what happened to those sensitive person? It is like this. For example, you go down the street and then you don't really realize, but so many trash on the street. Sometimes if you are very careful, you know that, oh, here's a trash or here's a dog poo, and then you try not to step on it, and then you can just nicely walk through the street without stepping on any other trash. But sometimes you are not careful and then you bump to something, but energy, talking about energy, because energy is invisible, maybe you might bump to something that's like a trash, yeah, on the street. So you bump to something, and then after you bump to that energy, like a bunch of energy bump to you, and then you also resonating and is influencing, so that's happening to you. So that's why you created some emotion even you don't understand. For example, you suddenly sad, you suddenly worried, or suddenly angry. You look at the person, they are so angry, or look at the sub person, you also create the sad emotion. So I think that's also very sensitive. But sometimes even you didn't look at the person, exactly they're showing their anger or worry or sad. But I think energy is like floating all the way around. Then you even the invisible energy bump to you, so you have the same thing. Have you ever happened that in the office, for example? So you open the door and then there was no one inside the room, but you can feel the sense, like for example, two person argument before you enter the room, but this two person already left the room. But after you enter, maybe about 10 minutes later, then you sense something wrong with the atmosphere of the room. So have you happened this before in your life? I guess that's also say that that's actually the proof that you are a sensitive person. Yeah, even we can't see the situation, we don't see anybody inside the room, but we can feel it, we can feel that something wrong with the energy or air in the room is not really fresh, and even you feel danger or you feel like very sad, and so that's kind of a negative thoughts or negative emotions, that is the proof that actually you influence by the energy. Yeah, even the people are not there anymore. So this is what happening in our life. Yeah, it is quite mysterious though, talking about energy, because if we are like a physical level, so we can see a lot of trash, and we can see the trash inside the, for example, on the street, and because I go beach cleanup before, so I can also see a lot of trash in the ocean now. So many trash. Actually, I think recently is really too many stuff. We don't really have to additionally increase the stuff anymore, but I think we have to find a way to how to cleanse it or how to reduce it. So these things, I think we have to do it at the beginning. In the energy level, we can also imagine actually our situation now. Recently, we have been like an energy trash, too many energy trash around us. We create too many stagnation around us, not just inside the body, but outside. That's also happening. And then we are like an emotional creature, so once we touch and they're easily affected, so it's like a virus, but the actually energy also affected. And then so you have your own, not the own emotion, but you also created some negative emotions as well. So this is called highly sensitive person. So what should you do if you are a sensitive person? So I have a several suggestion that you can try today. It's a very simple task. It's like so you take shower. Yeah, very simple and very very easy, I can say. Yeah, nowadays we can use shower to you know, the put the water over your body. It's very simple and very easy. You can try that. It's physically you are really cleansing your body. Actually, that's also helping you. Like emotionally, you refresh after the shower. So don't you feel so? Yeah, it's very easy, but that's also helping your energy cleanse as well. Yeah, you can try take more often shower. And another one, for example, I tell clients to do the breathing sometime. For example, they come here and receive Reiki in a session. I also suggest clients to do breathing practice because I found it is very helpful and a very easy practice. It's usually I tell them to do so, and then very simple tasks that they can follow, and then they will see the changes. But when you do the breathing technique, you can try your back straight. Yeah, you don't do like a, you know, not wrong posture, but you can make your back straight, and then you can try your breathing. If you try to do this nicely and correctly, it's also helping your energy passage cleanse as well. So this is really helping. So I think you easily recover and nicely better from those you know, like exhausting, tiring sensation. Yeah, you can try the breathing technique with the good posture. And then how about other things? So actually in our daily life, we have a lot of things we can try if you are oversensitive person. For example, the music also helping. So listen to the music, which is really calming and giving you comfortable. You can try listen to the music. It's really helping you to balance your energy again. Yeah, so this is highly recommend to do so. And another simple and very easy task is make your face smiley. Yeah, so this is really easy, but maybe sometimes you find it not easy. Like in the past, I also try, you know, like because in Japanese we say this phrase, if you keep your face smile, then good luck is coming to you. So of course we know that if you keep smiling face all the time, so it is good for you as well. But sometimes it's so hard as well, like when we are so exhausted and then tiring, don't know how to make your smiley face. Yeah, so that is really difficult for me because I learned Reiki, then I found the benefit. Actually, the Reiki attunement helping you to clear and cleanse passage as well. And then that is really powerful. Yeah, I found it very powerful method that you can also try if you are very, very sensitive person. Because after you receive attunement, you learn Reiki, you all do about, because you do practice Reiki, it's all about balancing your energy condition. So this is really helpful. It's really helping like your condition, the energy condition that moment, maybe you are easily get influenced from other things, but you if you know that how to balance your energy nicely, then I think you are quickly recover. So you find it recovery much faster than before. It's talk about energy is very tricky sometimes because it's invisible energy, then don't know what is this. I believe that learning Reiki, for example, feeling is very, very important. But when you want to nurture the feeling field, like for example, you also can learn a lot of things and your thinking can be deeper. So you can create deep thinking, and then so your thinking skill getting better. But I think feeling also have to be the same way, but the feeling and thinking cannot happen at the same time. When we learn and practice Reiki, actually all about feeling. It's not the thinking part, but you have to really work and practice more about the feeling so that you can know more about the feeling. But if you have a sure feeling, your Reiki practice become more confident. And then actually so your flow also getting better is also the proof that you can feel easily. Yeah, that's also true. But energy is also we talking about, so this is just the wavelengths. Yeah, the wavelengths, like so this is like energy is all the things actually coming from energy. The scientists Bill also say that now energy is like from the light particle at the beginning, but for example, they can create our body, is also create the object, so we are made from energy at the beginning. Yeah, in Japanese we say that actually the sickness coming from energy, that meaning that because your energy is not balanced and the energy is not good in condition, then you are naturally attracting your body become sickness. If you treat your energy well, then you can also treat, it's almost equal to treating your sickness as well. Reiki is not directly working to the sickness like general medicine. We are not working like this way, but if you can balance your energy yourself, then I think at least you have a lot of things to try and a lot of things to do in a daily basis to so that is like a healthy way. So you can really treat your body and mind better. So it's definitely working on your physical level. So that is it today, like what we want to tell, like if you are highly sensitive person, so what should I do? Do you have any situation, for example, if you are always get tired but don't know why, and like keep draining the energy but don't know why, so maybe because you are too sensitive person, you are getting too many influence from outside the world. Maybe downstairs or some places or too many places. Sometimes the people come to me like I talk about their problem is actually I have so many places that I cannot visit because I know that I'm totally exhausted, so I don't want to go there. But I have seen people, they are actually changing and improving a lot, like from before that they couldn't go out, but now they can be more free to go out, and then they can really no need to afraid about where I shouldn't or what kind of people I shouldn't meet. But I found the people changing like that way because I know that the people really help themselves to balance their energy. It's a lot of benefits we can get. So if you have this problem also, then I hope that this information helps. So I strongly suggest you learn Reiki. It's really helping your energy balance, and then that's really working with your highly sensitive person that situation, so you can try as well. If you learn Reiki, the receiving attunement is the must, so you have to receive attunement from Reiki teacher. In our Japan Reiki Association, we usually don't do any online attunement courses because in this period of the time, many people inquire about do you have any online attunement, but our school never do online attunement courses. So at the moment here in Hong Kong, I'm teaching here Reiki in Hong Kong. Otherwise, Nursling in Canada also teaching Reiki attunement in Canada. So I paste the information below in the comment section so you can find our detail. If you never done attunement, so you can also find us. Otherwise, you can also go to the website and search about any Reiki schools that you can receive attunement. But be careful that what kind of Reiki you are learning, because talk about Reiki, we have so many different kinds. So I definitely suggest you to check what they are teaching and the content, price, the teacher, etc. So it's good to know before you register the class. Yeah, because nowadays our life is so convenient. So once you click the button, you already register and you already complete the payment. But talking about Reiki, because we are learning Reiki, like which is invisible energy. So the best to you contact the school first and then to see that if you can learn Reiki from who and what kind of content and then what time and then, so all those information you check once. If you agree with it, then you can register the one class. Yeah, but I hope you have a very wonderful attunement experience with your teacher. And then after you receive attunement, so you have a lot of practice, is actually helping your energy. And then you find yourself is really quite recovery, like a getting a fast recovery. So hope you enjoy and Reiki help you more in the future. Okay, so thank you for watching our video. Please don't forget to subscribe our channel so you can also check more other information from our association. Okay, so thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.